Thank you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's really a pleasure to be here today. I do thank Professor Ghaleb and also Dr. Khafnar for inviting me here, and it's a pleasure to be among brothers. What I say today is my own. It's not official, because when you are official, you have to say yes or no, and nothing really deep. In the context of the questions that you have raised in the very good concept paper, I tried to answer one question, that how political Islam, or what I prefer, Muslim activism, because political Islam is subject to interpretation, but I think there is no doubt that there are Muslims who are active in politics. I think it's much better word, how they can be analyzed in the regional context today. And in answering this question, I have three sets of concepts, three baskets of concepts, which I think may be relevant. First is about Iran, second is about the region, and finally is about the normative process, which I think is useful for the future. On Iran, thanks God, today is the 39th anniversary of Iranian Revolution, and Iranian Revolution is entering its 40th year from tomorrow, which I think is a very important issue for Muslim activism, broadly speaking. How we can understand the Iranian Revolution in this context? ABC. A, achievements of Iran. I think achievements of Iran during these four decades are significant, but most importantly, what I think is political independence and institutional building, along with what I call modernization from within, and also being able to provide security to its citizen independently and not by reliance on the others. And I think these are great achievements. B, betweenness. I think still Iran is in a betweenness situation, especially what I call a turning point for generational change. There is a generational change, which I think is very important in this concept of betweenness. Finally, my C on understanding Iran is challenges. Iran is facing many challenges, which I think are not exclusive to Iran, but Iran as a state needs to address them. Normative challenges, domestic challenges, maybe the most important one is what we call economic justice or social justice and the challenges of economy. However, what's important about Iran as a lesson is the capacity to deal with challenges and to manage challenges. The challenges have been great, are great, and are going to be great, but I think what's important about Iran is its capability and capacity building in a broader sense of crisis management and also managing the challenges. Now, let me go to the region. How we can understand the region? Again, ABC, I think today our region, Al-Sharq, which I prefer to any other concepts about this region. You know, West Asia is good, Middle East is not good, but Al-Sharq is much more telling. However, our region, first of all, A, is full of asymmetries and plurality of actors. What I do mean? I mean that you have many actors today compared to the past, and they are not equal in their power and influence, and it creates a lot of space for action and also a lot of challenges. B, I think the region is in a state of bewilderness and ambiguity. I don't call it transition per se. There are at least three components to this bewilderness and ambiguity. One is international actors. Who knows what the United States is going to do in this region? Is it a new war? Is it withdrawal? Is it a combination of it? How the other international actors are going to do? The second is regional. I think regional actors these days are more important than international actors. And there is more space for regional actors to play. And finally, national actors, which are not on the exactly on the same size of regional players, they also matter. But what it has created is a space, great space of ambiguity, and instability is part of this ambiguity. Yes, but the region is not going to be stay in the same format. My see on the region is competition. Competition in both classical and modern way. Classical, yes, we have balance of power, search for power, and so on and so forth. But I think there is a competition on narratives. Narratives are highly competed these days in our region. Even today, which was very interesting to hear, just right now, narrative on World War I, World War II. I mean, these are new narratives on the region. I'm not going to side on these narratives, but I think the competition on narratives is highly important for understanding the region. Taking all this to account, let me go to my third, which is on the political Muslim activism and how I see them. Again, ABC. My A is actorship. I think there is no doubt that Muslims have become politically activists, and nobody can deny them. Yes, there are a lot of, as we heard right now, big suppression and dictatorship here and there, but I think Muslim activism is there, alive, everywhere, and this is not going to die. And clearly, this Muslim activism is a response to external hegemony, to domestic dictatorship, and also return to values and identity, to Islamic roots, to how we see our values. And I think, regardless of all fluctuations, this actorship will remain in different ways. My B would be buildership. I think political activism in the Muslim world needs to build itself, but also to build on different aspects. First is building concepts and relate them to reality. The concept of democracy and how it can be in conformity with our values, I think, is a building by itself, but it is a conceptual building. But also it requires a building in reality, and that means building between islands of the region. What's still, again, interesting for me about Al-Sharq idea, that there are different people, but these people should be bridged upon each other. And I think this is a building process which requires both conceptual and practical interactions. Finally, I think my C is a compass or a mapping for the future. If we are going to take our actorship more seriously and our buildership more seriously also, we need a map, a compass, a normative one, which, borrowing from Islamic values and Quranic verses, I think rationality, Muslim rationality, Islamic rationality should be the base. And we read in Quran, وَجَلَ الرِّسَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ, those who don't use their rationality would be in a bad state, would be in a dirty, let's say, dirty situation. And I think if we put this aql or rationality as the base, then there would come at least three components for activism and for leadership. One is identity building. By identity, I mean constructing identities in the way that is building the region together, not focusing on differences per se, but identities which incorporate, identities which are inclusive and bring everybody on board. Second, I think, is the concept of interest. The concept of interest is not just a materialistic, let's say, notion. It comes from aql. When you use your aql and rationality, you have to answer this question, what's to my interest? And I think what's to the interest of all is working together collectively and not losing sight. Finally, my final point here would be interdependence. Dr. Ghalib asked the relationship between Iran and Arab uprising. I think nothing in this region happens separated from other issues and regions. They're all related to each other. This region is interdependent. Yes, people may not see each other face by face, but I think the flow of ideas, images, narratives, notions fly so much. And furthermore, along with this conceptual interdependence, economically, we should be more interdependent. And I think a good example, which is very interesting, is how Iranian-Turkish relationship is becoming more interdependent, and interdependency, especially on the economic side, is gradually and incrementally seen on the stage. And I think this interdependence also should be on the social side and political side. To end, first of all, I think Iran is a good example. I don't mean it is an example to be followed by any other cases, but I think the values that Iran stands for during the last four decades still are valid. You know, we made a revolution based on a three-part motto, Istiqlal, Azadi, Jumhuri Islami, which means independence, liberty, and Islamic governance, or Islamic Republic. And I think the values are important, as the French motto, French Revolution motto still is valid and is echoing in the French politics, egalité, fraternité, and equalité. I think Iran is a player, remains a player, and regardless of the challenges, I think would be a part of this region, a part of Sharq, and Sharq, Iran needs Sharq, and Sharq needs Iran in this respect. Second, I think the region is in not a fixated situation. It is in flux. It is in the process of making, and we are, all of us, makers of this region. It is not contingent upon the others. We can make our destiny. My third and final conclusion would be, regardless of all challenges, if we use Muslim rationality and rely upon it, more identification of interests, more clarity in identity, and more independence, interdependence emerge, and we would be in a better situation. I remain hopeful. As a Muslim, I never give up, and I think this is very important to keep in mind, that yes, or disappointment has no place in our theology and in practice. Thank you.